de 10.000 subs. Concert violin giveaway. Q&A chocolate binging. Coffee drinking thing with me. And all that, of course, as far as my kids allow me to record this video for you. Well, first of all, I owe you, all 10,000 of you, every single one of you, a big fat thank you. And I will explain a little bit why exactly, and it might be a bit more than you think. And that's all of you, not only people, you know, buying my courses, but also people liking, commenting, sharing my work. And that is when I was 18, my father suddenly died. I paid myself through college, through the best university, a private university in Holland for business administration, and through conservatory for, yeah, obviously the violin, the thing that is now my daily work. Well, violin business, I didn't really think of that back then. And you know, I share a lot of perfect family things lately, and yeah, what I want to tell you, share with you, is that for me it hasn't been that perfect at all in 15 years after my father died. I was in relationships with men that were really bad for me, really bad. I was in really dark places, but yeah, my career went very well. I set up several successful businesses. I was awarded Entrepreneur of the Year. And also I did a lot of fun things, like horse riding a lot. I even owned a very big motorcycle, I traveled. For those interested, a Kawasaki ZZR 1200. Oh, and did I ever mention to you running for Dutch parliament and almost getting there? So I did a lot of fun things, but I was never really fulfilled, even how my business grew and that kind of stuff. And only in the last year, I met this awesome man who I married, and we were blessed with two beautiful babies, of course. Switched to baby number two. I did a lot of great things, had great corporate jobs, was really high potential, but of all that, true fulfillment and happiness and freedom, in a way, for me, came from getting a good husband, marrying, and having beautiful babies. And I'm not interested in babies at all, just my own babies. I mean, if I look at other people's babies, I'm like, oh, they're ugly. Don't let them hear it. you know, having your own kids is really the most beautiful thing in the world. And you can't even imagine the happiness and fulfillment that that is possible for you if you don't. So it's really hard to decide to have kids, because you don't know how it is, and people maybe just complain to you. But underneath, it's great. So and what I like to thank you for is that, thanks to the internet, I can be serving violinists worldwide, and that the internet allows me to specialize in my favorite topic, which is musical expression, bow technique, tone creation, vibrato, those things. That really allows me to live a life that is so great that I could have never imagined. I've been unhappy for many years of my life, and a lot of bad things have happened to all of you, perhaps, watching. And now it seems like everything is more perfect than I could have ever imagined. And you played a big part in that. And no matter how big the numbers get, I'm deeply, deeply thankful to all of you that I can express my talents, that I can share my love of music, and that my kids don't have to see a daycare inside, and that I have enough time to be there for them. So I'm not going to cry, but no. Every time you see one of my videos, that I make them from a place of enormous gratitude to every one of you listening. Okay, let's go into the Q&A. And in the meantime, you can drool over this beautiful Fiddlermaan culture violin that I'm about to give away. By the way, already watched my review video of the Fiddlermaan concert violin with funny voices, patent leather, and throwing a violin against the wall. Watch it right here. And we're getting really comfortable in here with some coffee. And what I also have, because you might be wondering, okay, I'm celebrating it by giving away a violin set. You might be wondering if I give myself something. I'd have been thinking about that. The number one thing that came to mind was chocolate, and I'm only allowed to eat chocolate because I have really no boundaries as it comes to chocolate, really none. It's terrible. I don't know, do you have a sort of food or drink that you just can't stop yourself? Leave a comment below what it is, or if it's perhaps chocolate as well. I really shouldn't buy it. I don't buy it. I just eat it with Easter, Christmas, childbirth, and YouTube milestones, like 10,000 subscribers. So I made myself comfortable to have some chocolate with my coffee. Yeah. Now, Louise, get your own violin and show these people how it's done, eh? Q&A time! Stidham family asks, do you ever play any fiddle style or bluegrass music on the violin? Well, actually, I'm a really, really classical, nerdy type of girl. I have done other styles. For example, I was the first violinist in a professional orchestra that mainly played jazz. We accompanied jazz soloists, movie music, and tango, that sort of stuff. That was really fun, but my heart is really with classical music, and that's also what I want to share. I enjoy fiddle music very much. I'm impressed by people who know like 1,000 tunes by heart and stuff. I'm very happy to work with fiddle preacher and teacher Bronwyn Beecher, who is a teacher in my program Bow Like a Pro, in which I teach all about bow technique and of course also the fiddle and the blues and all kinds of styles. But yeah, even I enjoyed her watching her videos, of course, because we worked together to create all that, and I wasn't tempted to play it. And there are so many centuries of musical gems in classical music that I feel that I need, you know, this life is too short for only that. Well, only that. So yeah, classical girl here. Yeah, did a lot of jazz improvisation courses, but for some reason it couldn't really interest me. Stidham family also asks, how old were you when you started playing violin, and how did you choose the violin as your instrument? I was 7 years old when I went to general music lessons, and I was always bullied a lot. Everywhere I was, and other children were, I was bullied. I was very nerdy, and had a strange name, and was a little pale and a little chubby. That's of course not a reason to bully someone. I was really shy, and there was a presentation of two girls who were a little like me, and they had this beautiful instrument, the violin. And I fell in love with it, with how it looks, you know, the frog, and everything looked so beautiful, the shape of the violin, how it sounds. And I had my first violin lesson on my 8th birthday. And, you know, at the time I felt like the violin teachers were angels, because there wasn't a place where I felt okay outside home and in the violin lesson, and, you know, meeting girls like me. That really felt like home, so that has played a big role. So the combination of the social thing and the violin itself, the sound, and it was really magical to me. So Puffin140 asks, have you ever done any busking? So performing on the street? Yes, but it's been 20 years ago or something. Even more than 20 years ago. Yes, I'm that old. when I was in school, middle school, I believe. I don't know your school system. I had a friend who played violin too, about the same level, and we went busking on Queen's Day. At that time, we had a queen in Holland. Now, we also have a queen, but the head of state is a king. So we have King's Day now, on another date. And yeah, we actually earned quite some money. I remember that it was like a lot of money, but it could have been like 10 euros and we bought a couple of candies and that was it or something. But yeah, it was a lot of fun. We played duos together. I think it was Dankla duos or Pleyel duos, something like that. And yeah, it was fun, but I didn't do the busking much after that. So I did it as a kid. Yeah. And Amanda and Gemma have asked, what is your favorite piece to play? That's a difficult question. And many classical musicians say, oh, there's so much and there are so many beautiful things and you can't compare them. But I thought it was a bit lame to say like, ah, you can't pick one favorite, it's all. So I have picked a favorite and it was really hard. And it's the second partita by Bach. And the sonatas and partitas by Bach are, yeah, they're always like coming home for me. In Dutch we say geen dag zonder Bach, which means, and it sounds probably to you like, but it means not a day without a Bach, and it actually is a rhyme. And I've been playing these since I was a kid. I had a wonderful teacher in the conservatory, and he said that he was never finished studying Bach. And I believe it was Brahms who said, study Bach, there you will find everything. And I think that is true. The one I like playing most is the second partita with the Chaconne inside. It's so beautiful and touching. I believe Bach wrote it after he came home from his travels and discovered his beloved wife had died. And then he composed that, and it just gives me the chills every single time. It just, Bach, for some reason, I'm never bored with Bach, even playing the same pieces for many years. I almost play them daily, so yeah, that's my favorite. By the way, on this beautiful Fiddlerman concert violin I'm about to give away, you can also play Bach. Here's the first sonata a little bit. By the way, don't play violin on your couch. It's very uncomfortable. Stuff that I would like to play, for example, the sixth violin sonata by Beethoven is one of my favorites. Brahms' violin concerto is, I think, my favorite out of all the big concertos. I like The Lark Ascending by Ralph Vaughan Williams. It's maybe one of the few pieces composed after 1900 that I actually like. And I love it. It's a kind of that improvisation style. What do I like more? Yeah, and the pieces I currently play are Mendelssohn and Mozart sonatas with my pianist. Debussy sonata for a violin is very beautiful as well. There are so many beautiful things. Well, I'm rambling. But just to give you an idea what I like to play. And then last question by... And then we go into the violin giveaway. by Eugenie. Hello Zlata, I have been following your YouTube for maybe 7 years now. Oh, it was so great that after, you know, over 400 videos, and there are people who are following me, and we meet in the comment section, of course, and they follow me for 7 years when I started the channel, and it's so great to have this, you know, I never met people, but I feel like I can kind of travel worldwide and meet people from different countries and really connect with them. That's the great thing about the internet. It just brings us closer together. Sometimes the internet brings us further away, but in this case, it really brings us closer together. And I love reading about, you know, how things go in other countries and stuff. Wow, that people follow me 7 years. It's great. Okay, And yeah, she says, always learn something from the videos. Well, good to hear that. What can I do to get my love for the violin back, as I think as I lost it in the past year? Ooh. As I can still not play beautiful after trying for 10 years. I think I have lost hope. Well, first of all, the thing about playing the violin is, if you would have heard yourself play after those 10 years, 10 years ago, so if you could do time capsule future traveling thing, then you probably would be very impressed by what you have achieved, and you would probably not be able to imagine that you could play so well. But the problem with practicing is that, you know, first your standards and your ears develop, and after that your playing follows. So, you know, and so your ears are always thinking, I'm not good enough. Even for big soloists, if you read interviews with them, they are always very critical about themselves and insecure and that kind of things. Not everyone, of course, but a lot of them. And so know that you have progress, that you play so much better than in the beginning, but that you maybe just don't see it yourself. Yeah, just have trust that you get, that you have progress. You know, and I thought that if I would graduate at a conservatory, that I would be awesome all the time and be completely happy with my playing and play perfectly and could be able to play anything. But still, like, I study this Bach already for my entire life until now. You can always improve, and you will never get... And that's the interesting thing about music, isn't it? It's not about getting it perfect. It's about getting progress and expressing yourself, enjoying playing it. You should be interested in, how can I improve this? And how can I do this better? And not that you think, okay, I want to be on this level and I'm not there, so I'm going to beat myself up for not being able to do something. And for me, it's been so valuable to realize that, to enjoy the process and not so much the goal. And you will get to goals. I also play things like Paganini Capricious. I thought I could never play them. There was a point that I had so much stage fright that I thought I could never graduate from the conservatory. But it all works out. So focus on progress, not perfection. And she writes further, I think I have lost hope. I have no teacher where I live and are totally dependent on lessons online. The physical teacher standing next to me is missing, and that leaves a great gap in the teaching. Any advice? Yes, certainly. What I noticed is that you are a BLP'er. You are in my program Bow Like a Pro, but I noticed that you didn't make use of the opportunities to send in as many videos for feedback as you want. So I would really like to encourage you to send in more and more videos, so I can point you to the exact module that you need. If you log into Bow Like a Pro, then in the top menu bar you'll see Get Feedback or Ask Questions, and then I can help you further. So I can definitely guide you in there, so you're already in the right place. All of you who have the same problem, I personally specialize in bow technique, tone creation, expression, vibrato, etc. But I do it in a video curriculum and through video exchange. If you are a type of person that, and you probably know this of yourself, that learns the best from live one-on-one guidance, then you might want to check out the website playwithapro.com, and there you can find so many awesome teachers, and you can have live lessons with them through their platform. So it's a lot better than Skype lessons, and it's really easy to use. So that might be a good solution, but I would start with logging again into Bow Like a Pro and sending me a video, what your problem exactly is, and I can help you further from there. So Eugenie, I'm sure I can get you through this plateau and you can have great progress in the coming time. Well, just needed to leave because the the kids needed food and I have a pile of towels here now situation and they both have a bottle in their mouth while mommy is going to finish this video. And of course after that I'm going to give them some well-deserved love and attention. Oh, and just to create a little bit more suspension, another topic. With 10,000 subs I'm planning to launch merch, maybe, I don't know yet. Let me know in the comments if that's something you'd be interested in, like beautifully designed violin shirts, mugs, I don't know, a sheet music bag, a violin phone case, something like that. Let me know in the comments if you want it and what you would like to see, like a long sleeve, a hoodie, a shirt, or whatever. They will be beautifully designed, but I need to know from you if you would appreciate. So what you can win today to celebrate my 10,000 subscribers is this beautiful Fiddler Man concert violin. And it comes with a bow, a beautiful case, rosin shoulder rest, violin back, mute, everything you need actually. And if you haven't seen my review yet, I'll link to it underneath so you can watch it and see if this is a violin you want to get. And I'm sure it is. You know, with these giveaways, I actually don't like and share things and, you know, hysterical stuff. So I was thinking about a way to do the giveaway, but in a way that it is educational. The last time I did a violin giveaway, someone actually got mad on me because he didn't win. So I am trying to find a way in which everyone will be happy. And I get also a lot of comments that people don't have the funds to invest in a good instrument. I've run a violin shop for 12 years. As I know that there are a lot of people who really can't afford it, who are really on a tight budget, who have really no time, no means to make extra money or to cut expenses or anything. But in my violin shop experience, I've learned that, and I'm not saying that this is the case for you, but that in maybe 99% of the cases, people don't have the priority for it. They smoke a box of cigarettes a day and then in the end they don't have the money for a violin, for example. I have an opportunity, so I'm not going to, because I can't check if it's legit, I'm not going to give this violin away because someone's saying that they can't pay for it themselves, because I can't judge that, simply because I can't judge that. If you don't have funds for a violin, there is a great way to earn some extra income working for Violin Lounge. Well, isn't that fun? You can find that opportunity at violinlounge.com/ambassador. What I want to do is throughout January, so until the end of January, I'm going to look at all the comments, as I always do, and I'm going to give the violin away to someone who is learning a lot and promoting my work for, you know, the good of everybody, of course. Because if someone comments below my video and if someone watches my video, YouTube thinks, hey, that might be a good video and I'm going to suggest it to more viewers. And in that way, more people can benefit from my work. So that's what I'm going to reward. And the advantage of this is that what I want you to do is go through my videos, the newer ones or the very old ones, and comment below them what you've learned. And in the end of January, I'm going to see who's most active, who has done the most implementing and the most progress, and I'm going to give the violin away to that person. And in that way, even if you don't win the violin, don't get mad at me if you don't, then you've still learned a lot. Then I still have given you a motivation, stimulation to go through the videos, really apply it in your playing, practice, really benefit from it, learn something from it, and yeah, you know, then we are all winners. So that's what I want you to do. The way to win this Fiddler Man concert violin is throughout January, and of course also after that, to be very active in the comments. And then I don't count how many comments, because I'm going to look at quantity as well as quality. So I'd rather have you comment on less videos, but comment in a way that I can actually see that you have applied it in your playing and that you've really benefited from it. I'd rather see that in fewer comments than that you just spam my whole channel with posting below every video, "I've learned a lot from this." No, I want to know what you learned from it exactly. So that's my assignment. I hope it's clear. If it's not, let me know in the comments. So I'm looking forward to see what you all are going to learn in the coming days. And don't spend all your practice time on YouTube. But yeah, let's do it. Let's go.